adventure. It will never cross my way. Want to be wild.
What kind of fucking bus ride acts like this?
Hello. Thank you, Marcel.
Fucking being scared of his own family.
Just show you what happens here. So after I drill through them, I just want to try and get this out. So it is stuck with a little bit of sticky stuff. I don't know what it is, but sticky stuff is sticking it. I'm doing this with my left hand, so but just so you guys can see. And then I just pry that off. So there's no rivets holding it now. Just this sticky stuff, and it does still hold quite well. Alright, so I just work my way there. Chuck this in. Oh, there's a rivet there. I forgot that. Anyway, so that's what happens. Now, the reason I did that is because I want to take off this bit here because I want to isolate basically this room. So now I'll be able to remove they're such big panels. They're fucking massive. But anyway, I'll be able to remove this panel, and then in this room, I'll then be able to... there is a little bit. I've got to drill through the rivets in here because those rivets are holding up this sheet. There's about two on each side, so I've got to do that and then take that down. What I'm trying to do is to basically isolate this bathroom here. Most importantly, it'd be good to get rid of this one first, but yeah, both got to go. So if I isolate that room, I can put in some things. I can put in some roofing here with plywood inside the bathroom and seal it off completely. And that's my main aim, I guess, at the moment, is to try and seal off this bathroom. Doesn't mean I'll do it today. I'm just going to try and get closer to that stage. So, you start scratching at an itch. And then it becomes real fucking like a problem. But basically, this is what's happened in here. As you can see, most of the foam, I've taken the foam out from the bathroom area, I probably wouldn't have done this, but that can down there is expander foam. So really, I was sitting there going, what's the fucking difference, right? What's the difference? So there's none. There's no difference. So what I'm thinking is I just expander foam all the way up into this area and around here, fill it up. Fill it up, and basically in here, in this spot, I'll just cut along, and then that'll give me my wall that I need up here, and it won't interfere too much with what's going on. And if anything, if I need to get some wires through or something, I can just drill through it. Yeah, and then from there, what I can do here is I can then start doing this wall. Nothing could possibly go wrong. What's this set up for? Alright, well, that's fucking messy. I thought it might be. I'm gonna go all in with this. I'm gonna continue to do it. So I'm gonna go to the store and get some, probably like 3 or 4 cans of that. 5, 6. I'm just gonna go all in and do it until it's done. I'm committed to it, and it looks okay. You know, if I hadn't been told that this works, I probably would be pretty fucking scared or panicky right now. I have used this stuff before, but not like this. That's how we're going there. Gotta stand it up and knock the back off that. Hopefully that should make it considerably lighter. And hopefully the back will come off quite easy. It is sticky taped quite well. So let's see how we go. You know, this, I just really, really wish I hadn't done this, but what I am going to do is I'm going to have to sand it all the way back to wood here, and it is quite a bit of way down, but at least I've got it out of there, and this is the underside, so I could always do something underneath it to cover up my mistakes, but for now we have accomplished the impossible, and there is all these little bits of resin. It's pretty much like glass, so I'm gonna pick them all up and put them away. Okay, so I'm gonna give this a bit of a brushing on this side and get this off. And I really am thinking that underneath I'm either gonna leave it the way it is, or I'm gonna apply one of these aluminium sheets and stick it to the bottom, and then I can just, you know, have that as the bottom of it, so it's got a steel bottom. And you won't see the rubber. But do I, you know, have it on the bottom and it be under this? Like, what? I don't know what that would look like, so I'm gonna have to check. Do I want this to be clear? So you could see through to the bottom. Will that really matter? Because, you know, if it's a bench, and it's sitting over, you know, against the wall of the bus, you're never really going to go around this side at the back of it. So, yeah, things to consider. getting there. It's going to take a long time, but I don't think the sand is going to be any good, but yeah, we might have to sand it as well. But, yeah, for the time being, I just want to get off these like really protruding bits here. Yeah, I think I fucked my hello. I fucked my drill. I think I burnt the motor. It's just stuck, the button's stuck and I smelled some fucking, anyway. I'm gonna use this now. And hopefully I won't also fuck this up. I just cut the length for this, and now I'm going to take off this bit, and I'm going to attach this bit here, this, if you can see without the sun, this frilly bit, and I'm going to attach that to there, making enough length, I hope. So when the door closes, it just, you know. I do kind of wish it were a little bit, you know, I could cut this, because I kind of wish it were, if you can see, it's hanging on the inside when it closes. So, maybe I could just chop it a little bit. Let's see what it looks like from the outside. So yeah, if I cut that maybe a little bit, even that, does the job though. I've cut it to size, I've changed the disc, I'm just going to clean up a bit, because it's messy. That took 5 seconds. That took 5 seconds, so I'll just do the edge bits here, and then I'm going to figure out a way to fix it to the door. Got a visitor. Hey! Hello, Bello! Bello the fluffy dog, hey? Hey! Ugh. Don't piss on me when you... I get so excited, he pisses me. Come on, let's go back home. Alright, I removed this and then a whole bunch of my metal filings fell out. There. They were just piled up in there. Anyway, that doesn't need to be on there. So now what I can do is I was having an issue because it wouldn't fit because of that bar, and now it should fit. So I might actually do some more holes, but do them just a tad bit higher, because it seems a little bit low. It's like right where the bottom of it is. So I'm going to do some more holes, but just have them in the middle of this. Alright, I fucked that up. I fucked it. I mean, there's a lot of holes in this now. And basically, that can go get fucked. I've got another idea. And that is, I'm going to make these go like that, and I'm going to put them under there. Okay, I've cut that to size. And it fits way too snugly if I'm going to put it down this way. It kind of grinds. So what I'm going to do is I might go up that way, alright, and then I've got this, and if you'll remember, this is all the like bit that used to go on the side over here. Yeah, so I'm going to cut a length of this to this size, and then I'm going to affix it to there, and have it hanging down there, and that's what the plan is. Alright, here's what I've manufactured. Never mind the extra holes. but basically, I've created this. And this is the other half. So I'll show you what I've done. I've basically cut this in half from that piece, which I showed you before. I've obviously cut it to length. And then once I've cut this in half, I've then cut this bit off to flatten it. And I've then got this piece here. And now what I've got is these two holes that'll screw into the bottom of there, and then this will hang out and be like that. So I'm going to put it in now and show you. If that all goes to plan, then what I will do is I will put some glue in between here. I might even then put a couple of rivets with some washers, maybe. Will that work? Maybe some bolts. I could possibly use a bolt. Glue should be enough anyway. The glue, and then from there I'll glue the inside of this, and then that'll stick to that, as well as screwing it in. And then we've got a good bond. And basically, what'll happen is it'll close, and that lip will sit. It's longer, so it'll sit outside, so if any water comes, it'll just off the edge. Feel me? Alright, let's give it a go. Sags, but let's take a quick gander. feel me? You feel me? Right? So once that is there in that, like once that's up there, it's gonna be fucking perfect. Okay, these are bracket things. And what I've done is I've just cut one of these squares off. The reason I've done that is to make a washer. So that's a washer, and this is the one that I've made. Basically, what I can do with that is I grab one of these rivets, and I put it in, and that's going to go in there. Okay, I'll show you, because it's hard to do with one hand, but there. Okay, and basically what I want to do is go into there, and I need the washer there to hold it so that, because the rivet is not wired enough, that I think that it's going to hold as I pull it. So, just a little tip for you, I guess. Something I've learned to do. So I've created 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 holes there for the rivets. And I've got enough. I've created some more of these out of that. So now I have 5 of those. Well, I've got 4 of those and one of these circle ones. So these ones will end up, hopefully this one is, it might be a good idea just to make one more, because this circle doesn't quite fit in that area. So I'm going to cut one more off there. There it is. Just careful, because they can get hot and sharp. So anyway, so there's my 5 now. I'm not going to use the circle one. These ones will fit nicely in this gap. So I'm going to take out these screws here. I'll probably leave one in. Just to line it up maybe, and then I'll take it out, and then I'm going to glue these together. I'll clamp them and put the rivets in, bang bang. I'll leave it clamped, and I'll probably just leave that overnight. Alright, well, I hope this fucking works. I'm gonna need to put this down for a bit, but I'm just gonna squeeze these through the holes. That glue sticks on there real well. So I'm gonna do this quick. But you can see the first one's on there, and I'm gonna continue to do them down there. I'm just going to try and bang this in right now. Now, this is going to be a little bit more difficult to put in this time, I think. So, let's pray. Let us pray. If you do things enough, they'll finally work out. Let's check this out. And I think that's a good install. It's a bit tight to push in, but at least you know it's fucking, you know, once you're in, you know it's in, you know? So, that's fucking it. I'm just gonna let that sit there and fucking think about its actions for a tick. That's terrible. Gross. Gross. It's not gross, it's just fucking annoying, that's all it is. So, Maybe I should reuse this. I would just have to cut it each place that I've made the hinge. But that would work. Okay, so it took a lot of brain power, but I've cut, as you can see, this to size. So it'll skip the hinge, but it'll still cover the metal bracket bit here. But I've then cut out this bit here from there, so that it'll sit flat against that bit. And same goes there. It's going to take a little bit of maneuvering to get it in there, but so far I've done this without making it separate pieces. Fantastic. Now, I've clamped it up there so that what I can do now is I'm going to measure out the same for the other two hinges, and I'm going to try and keep it one piece and put it back in one piece. I figure if I just keep being persistent, it's going to eventually get in there. Guess what? It's not in. I'm thinking maybe if I cut this off completely, because all I'm trying to do right now is seal the wind from going in back there. I'm not really fucking... I don't really care about that so much. It's simply, I just want to get it in there, have that seal, have this as the seal at the back. So I'm going to take it out, slice all of that bit there off, all of that from this side off. Okay, I've got one in at the bottom, and what it is I cut these bits off here that were covering this bit, because they make it sort of flare out, and when it flares out, it pops out. The main thing for me is that this seal here is going to stop the wind coming in. So I'm going to try and do the rest now. Okay, I think I can. Yeah, it's in. Let's see if it closes. I've spent pretty much all fucking day on this, so I hope it fucking works. There's one thing I gotta do, and that's cut out this bit here. But I reckon that's gonna work very, very well. That's perfect. So, all I've got to do here, so that it will close, is to remove. I'm going to cut out just a little bit here. Are you dead inside? Come help me fight this medical apartheid. Dead inside. Taking our freedoms and our lives. Cast your masks aside. Come help me fight this medical apartheid. Dead inside. A little freedom in our lives. Yes, it fucking works. Check it out. Locked and it's in. Look at that seal. Baby! And I mean, I fucking wrote a song idea, well, it's an idea, while I was here all day on this. I come up with a song, so I'm pretty happy with that. But check this out. Check out that seal. Hang on, let me just throw some light on it. Right? goes all the way down over here, bam, and keep going. Look what it's covered too. It's covered the hinges. Let's go take a look what it looks like outside. Outside looks good, and that has got to have stopped the wind there. So the only one left is just a little tiny bit here. We'll figure that out. But so yesterday we done that and the top, today we've done the top of the top there plus this seal down the side. I'm pretty happy with that. Whoop. Hey, how do you think about that? I don't even know if that's English. Locked. Great, huh? That's great. And no more wind. No more wind from here. You can't. There's no more wind. What's happening here? Oh, yeah, that's that little fucking seal thing. So, pretty happy there. I am going to cut this off because it's causing quite a bit of friction. And if you can see, that's kind of what stops it here, is this stuff. See, like when I move that, the door wants to move in. So that's definitely going to get a haircut. Song idea. Are you dead inside? Help me fight this medical apartheid. Dead inside. Come help me fight this. Help me fight. Cast your masks aside and help me fight this medical apartheid. Dead inside. Help me fight this. Help me help.
Believe in all the lies they find.